So far, we have introduced various notions such as graded modules, chain complexes, short exact sequences, long exact sequences, diagram chasing technique, then using that four lemma, five lemma, and then the big result, namely the snake lemma. Okay, this snake lemma is going to be a good feedback, going to give you a good application. Very soon you will see that. So, guided by the experience in complex analysis or in differential equations and so on, or studying differential forms and so on, so we are led to measure the deviation of a chain complex being exact, from being exact. And that is precisely the role of these homology modules, the homology groups, okay, associated to a chain complex. By the very definition, a chain complex has an operator DABA, self operator, of degree minus one, such that the D square is zero, which just means that the kernel of D or DABA, whatever you want to say, kernel of DABA contains the image of DABA. So how far the difference between the image and the kernel is what we want to measure, one being a subgroup of the other, or one being a submodule of the other. So a nice way to measure this thing is to take the quotient. And that leads to the definition of homology groups as a graded module now. Okay, so let us make formal definitions. Start with the chain complex C star. The homology groups of C star to be a graded R module, okay, so denoted by H star of C, which is the direct sum of HN of C's. So each HN is a module, and I am taking direct sum over that, where C star itself is graded over that. C star itself is direct sum of CNs, right? So what are these HNs I have to define? After that, H star is defined as a direct sum. Okay, so H star of C star, HN of C star is defined as kernel of DABA N by the image of DABA N plus 1. Remember, DABA N plus 1 starts from CN plus 1 to CN, and DABA N starts from CN to CN minus 1. So the kernel and image are both submodulus of CN. Okay, so the image of DABA N is contained inside kernel of DABA N. Therefore, the quotient makes sense, and this will be an R module. Okay, define this one for every N like this, and take the direct sum. That is the entire homology group of C star. So what you have done is the homology groups associated to a chain complex. The beauty of this is that you can make it into a functor. So that is our next object here. If you have a morphism from C star to C star prime, another chain complex, remember a morphism of chain complexes consists of a sequence of module homomorphisms CN to CN prime such that they commute with the corresponding DABA operators here, DABA here and DABA prime here. They are compatible with the structure. Okay, therefore What happens is a chain map has a property that kernel of Dabba n will be contained inside the kernel of Dabba n prime. Image of Dabba n plus 1 will be contained in image of Dabba n plus 1 prime. This is the consequence of Dabba composite F is equal to F composite Dabba. Okay, and hence, by the isomorphism theorems of modules or just for homology, just for abelian groups, what we get is this F very F induces a graded homomorphism, which I will denote by H star of F. H star consists of various homomorphisms now. You can write it as Hn of F if you like, from Hn of C star to Hn of C prime star. So the entire thing I am writing H star in the obvious way. Namely, okay, restrict F to kernel of Dabba n prime, kernel of Dabba n, it will go inside that. Then quotient it by this one. So in the image also you have to, you can quotient by this one. Okay, so this gives you the corresponding homomorphism. The very nature of this is such that if you have another map from say G from C prime to C double prime, okay, then G composite F will have similar properties. Okay, so what happens is H composite H star of G composite F will be H star of G composite F star of H. Similarly, H star of identity is identity. So this is what we get, H star of G composite F, F, FG I have taken G this way. So H star of F and H star of G. Thus, H star will be a covariant functor. From where? From the category of chain complexes to the category of graded modules. When you pass on to the homology, there is no chain complex now. We have lost the Dabbas here. Okay? So this functor is called the homology. Homology associated to a chain complex only. Later on, we will associate it to different things. Okay. The simplest thing now to prove is the so-called weak additivity of the homology functor. Namely, homology commutes under direct sums. The homology of a direct sum of chain complexes is isomorphic to the direct sum of homology of chain complexes. It is easy to verify this one, you know, routine for direct sum of two chain complexes. Okay, but then you can realize it that there is nothing very special about two. The same argument will go through any number of components, infinitely many components, direct sum. Okay, so such verifications we will leave it to you, because these are just practicing with the homology of homomorphisms and abelian groups and so on. That's all. Okay, so above property of homology, namely direct sum of chain complexes, will give rise to direct sum of the corresponding homologies. Okay, so this is, you can call it as additivity of the homology. Okay, so what we would like to do is, let me go back to this chain the exact sequences of, where was the exact sequences of modules and so on of chain complexes, like this, okay, of chain complexes like this, C prime to C to C double prime, exact sequence of chain complex, short exact sequence of chain complex, wherein The middle one may not be the direct sum of these two. So how is this related to the homology of this one and homology of this? So this is what we would like to. Can you expect that homology will be also related by the same kind of exact sequences like this? In other words, I am asking, suppose you have this one, then you apply homology here. Then you get 0, h star of c prime, h star of c double prime, 0. 0 will go to 0 anyway. So would that be exact? What is easy to see that G composite F is a 0 map of the chain complex here. Therefore, H star of that will be also 0. So the composite of these two will be 0. This composite, this is 0. Right? This composite is 0 and so on. But if this is exact, will that one be exact? That is not clear at all. Right? It is a chain complex. Composites are, it's one that will give you the corresponding composites are also 0. So if this is exact, means kernel of G is equal to image of F, then it is not at all clear whether the homology will have that property. Indeed, let us go back here now. So that is the kind of thing we want to study. Let us go back here. Okay. So this is the question one we want to ask, namely, do we have H star of C dot isomorphic to the direct sum of H star of C prime and H star of C double prime? If that is too much, at least do we have a corresponding short exact sequence of homology modules? Okay, the answer to both of them are negative in that strong sense. But you go a little, relax a little bit, then you get a beautiful, correct answer. Well, correct answers are always beautiful. And that is given by application as an application of the snake lemma. Okay, so this is the kind of additive you will be interested in. However, answer in general is no. So we are forced to refer to the proper homology groups, property of homology groups as in theorem 3.1. Okay, weak additivity. The best thing that we can say about this additivity of homology follows from theorem 3.2. Then theorem 3.2 is the snake lemma. So here is the here is the theorem 3.2 that we are going to present here now. This is the best thing that we can show. So what is the meaning? What is the statement? Given a short exact sequence, now I am writing down the maps also here, alpha and beta. Maybe earlier I wrote it as alpha, F and G. Okay, this is short exact sequence of chain complexes. Remember, this means that there's a whole lot of chain, short exact sequences of modules here. Each C prime n, Cn and C double prime n. And there is a commutative diagram. It's alpha and beta and etc. will commute with the boundary operators there. So that is the meaning of this. Once you have such a thing, there is a functorial long exact sequence of homology groups. Okay? And it's denoted like this, namely dot dot dot, it starts from somewhere because this n is going from minus infinity to plus infinity, right? So at nth level, what happens? Hn of c prime, the corresponding hn of alpha here to hn of c, then hn of beta. This is exact, means this is exact. Okay, but from here, where do you go? It is not exact here. This is the point. Okay. So Hn of C prime you have landed, but next thing will not be 0. So what you will get? hn minus 1 of c prime. Okay, so hn minus 1 of c prime. Then the three terms again repeat, namely hn minus 1 of c dot, hn minus 1 of c prime, c double prime. Again, this will go to hn minus 2. So that is the meaning of this dot, dot, dot. That is the meaning of this dot, dot, dot on the previous. So this long exact sequence, this long sequence is exact. That is the meaning of long exact sequence of homology groups. And then there is this functorial one. Now, is it easy to guess what the meaning of this functorial means? If you make this one as a category, which we have already done, category of short exact sequences of chain complexes, then there is a functor to the long exact sequences of modules and module homomorphisms. What is that? H. Hn, Hn, there is a way it is done. Okay, and that is exact, and association is a functor. Okay, so this is a consequence of the snake lemma now. So the snake is appearing here, you see. So this is going to be our delta. The corresponding, we had a delta there also. We are not going to distinguish and introduce too many notations. So delta was there to remind you that this is also something to do with that. We are putting the delta, same delta here. So just to recall what was the in the snake lemma, let us see what we had got here. From M prime, M to M, this was a snake. And then we had kernel of F prime to kernel of F to kernel of beta, and then the snake delta to co-kernel of F prime, co-kernel of F, and co-kernel of F double prime. This is six term exact sequence. So this was the snake there. And the association was functorial. This is functorial. So one sequence, another sequence, there is a morphism there. So this is what we had verified. Now we will use that to prove this theorem, which is not at all difficult, but you have to guess how to get these terms out of this kernel and co-kernel. So that is an elementary module theory or elementary abelian group theory. Okay. The chain maps, homomorphisms they are, remember, alpha and beta, respectively induce chain maps of quotient modules. I am not directly going to the homologies here, okay? So take C prime star, I mean C prime N. If you want to put N everywhere, you can go on putting it. Okay, C prime star divided by the image of dava prime. So this is the co-kernel of dava prime. Okay, C star by the image of dava. Similarly, beta bar from C star of image of dava, C star by image of dava to C double prime by image of dava prime. Okay, these are co-kernel of correspond image of dava prime here, image of dava here, image of dava prime here, image of dava here. Okay. Also, upon restricting to kernel of alpha, kernel of dava prime, kernel of dava, you can just restrict alpha. You can just write alpha itself or alpha prime, I've written. Alpha prime and beta prime, which are restrictions of that. So kernel to kernel. Okay. For each n, we then have a snake as follows. Now, out of this one single sequence, I am writing a snake now. Okay, from the snake, I will get a six-term sequence. putting all the six term sequences together, I will get the long homology XAP sequence. So these are the two steps there I have to do. So how to get a snake, first step. Okay. So this is a snake. Remember, snake had one zero on the top and another zero at the bottom coming from here. So this is my M prime, M double prime, N prime, N double prime in the snake. C prime by image of Dava prime, C prime by image of Dava N plus prime, C double prime by image of Dava N plus. These were the co-kernels of some other steps. These were the kernels of some steps. Okay. Now we apply the snake lemma to that. Take the kernel here, kernel here, kernel here, co-kernel here, co-kernel here, co-kernel here. And see what are those six groups. They happen to be the six terms which I am interested in, namely these six terms. And they will be connected by this delta. Okay. So the snake always gives you the six term sequence, right? So notice that the kernel of this map, Dava N prime, this map, this is induced by Dava prime. Okay, it's induced by Dava prime. Dava prime is a Cn prime to Cn minus 1, but it has gone into kernel. But this part goes to 0 in any case under Dava. When you compose with this one, this goes to 0. That's why this map is defined. Remember that. It's a kernel. The same thing as kernel of Dava prime divided by the image of Dava N plus. And that is why it is the homology corresponding. This is nothing but kernel of Dava prime divided by image, it's HN of C prime. Okay, there must be a prime here, sorry. Okay, so it's isomorphic to kernel of Dava prime by the image of Dava N plus 1 prime. Okay, this is Dava N plus 1 prime here. Likewise, this will be HN of C, and this will be HN of C double prime. And what are the co-kernels of this? Okay, the co-kernels are also, you can just look at what is the meaning of co-kernel. You take this one, okay, image of this, quotient out by the image of that. The image of this here is same thing as image of Cn prime, which is nothing but image of Dava N prime, and divided by the kernel of Dava N minus 1, this is the Hn minus 1 of Hn minus 1 of prime, Hn minus 1 of C prime, Hn minus 1 of C, Hn minus 1 of C. Okay. So put them together, what you have got is this part. But this is true for every n. And what happens just behind this one, that is precisely the same delta at one stage lower. So all the hard work is done by the snake lemma. So here we are just reaping the harvest. Let us now introduce a important concept here, which is guided by the homotopy in the topological spaces. But how you got this one, you may wonder, but to understand this one, you have to wait, or you will understand it if you have done something like Poincaré lemma in your differential topology. Okay, so these things were cooked up from experience. Poincaré lemma, for example, tells you what you have to do. So chain homotopy is purely algebraically defined here. So if you just see it like this without knowing all these things, you will lose the motivation why it is done. So you have to just cook up, you have to just mug it up till you see a little more, and then you see, oh, these two things are fine. Okay, given two maps, module graded homomorphisms of degree zero between two chain complexes, we said they are chain homotopy. If there exists a graded homomorphism D star from C star to C star prime of degree one, okay, these are degree zero maps, this is degree one map, such that capital D composite Daba plus Daba prime composite capital D is F minus G. Okay, it's easily verified. When I say easily verified, this, there is work for you to do. Okay, the chain homotopy D star is a chain homotopy. If there is such a thing exists, then F and G are chain homotopy. Okay, so this chain homotopy is an equivalence relation. The important thing to see that is F is homotopic to G, G homotopic to H implies F is homotopic to H. Okay. So this is not at all difficult. You have to just see that it's an equivalence relation. The idea behind this definition will be clear when we consider the topological situation from which it has emerged. So that is why word homotopy is there. Okay, the important property of chain homotopy that we are interested in, why we have brought it here, is the following bearing of this one in the homology. Chain homotopic maps induce the same homomorphism of homology groups. Once you have said this one, verification is totally easy. Okay, so you have F and G, you have to take the nth level, what happens to Hn of F? An element in Hn of C star is represented by an element in the kernel. Represented by modulo the image. So take F of that, okay, modulo the image, corresponding image there in the C prime star, right? You have to show that G is also like that. G of that element is also same. That is what you have to show, okay? So if you look at this one, F minus G for any cycle here, cycle means an element of something which is Daba of something. Okay, if some element is Daba of something, when you put that element here, okay, this you don't know what happens, but this part will be zero. D of Daba will be zero. So it's Daba of D of something. But if it's Daba prime of something, therefore, the difference, this element is in the image of something, so it gets killed. Therefore, fx minus gx will be zero when applied on an element x which is in the kernel of Daba. So I have proved it for you anyway. So you write down the details now, that's all. So exercise has been taken away already. You just write it down. Let us stop here. We will pick it up from here next time.